Hello, this is James with LotHill. Today I'm going to go over a couple things regarding cash footprint point of sale and the back-end database service. Some people are having issues with upgrades to Windows 10 or performing Windows updates automatically, and Windows will stop the service, perform the updates, and then sometimes not restart the service, which is causing cash footprint to display a message saying waiting for server to load. And that'll be followed by a network-related instance error that will not allow CashFootprint to start properly. So first thing we're going to do is just double-check the services that are required for CashFootprint to load and make sure that they're running properly. So Windows 10, Windows 8, you should be able to right-click the Start button, go to Control Panel. You can also use the charms, click on Search. Windows 7, you can go to the Start button, Control Panel, System and Security, Administrative Tools, and then Services. So I'm just going to search for services this way. Services, there we go. And View Local Services. The other way I mentioned for Windows 7, go Start button, Control Panel, System and Security, Administrative Tools. That's going to get you into the same screen. So once we're into the services, I want you to scroll down and find SQL Server. You can just type SQL and it'll bring you right down there. SQL Server, SQL Express. This is the default. So if you install the database instance and just run through this SQL Server Express install, this is what you're going to see. If you follow the instructions that we give out with the CD, as well as online and YouTube for the step-by-step, you will see SQL Server, and in parentheses you'll see CashFootprint. So regardless, double-click on the SQL Server, either SQL Express or CashFootprint. If you named it something else and you're aware of that, go ahead and open that up. Make sure the start type is set to automatic for anything other than Windows 10. Windows 10, I want you to set it to delayed start. Everything else, do automatic. Hit apply and then start. Mine's already running, so once it's all started and everything, you should see SQL Server Express running and start type is automatic. We want the same situation to be set up for the SQL Server browser. This is what shares that instance of the server on the network. So SQL Server with your name, SQL Server, SQL Express, or CashFootprint, that's the instance of the server that's running for your database. And SQL Server Browser will share it on the network. So if you have more than one computer using this computer as its database, so you're sharing this computer out to the others, this one needs to have the browser running, or CashFootprint on the other computers won't be able to see it and it won't be able to connect. So double click on that. Start type, make sure that's automatic, hit apply and start, and then hit OK. So these should both be running, and they should both be set to automatic, or if you're using Windows 10, automatic delayed start. That's it for making sure the services are up and running for CashFootprint. Now if you have a multi-user environment, multiple registers, I think our largest client has 30 terminals, so their main computer is set up with these particular services and they are running, they're both set to automatic. All the other clients, they don't install the server software, they just install CashFootprint and then they point to this machine, so the browser needs to be running to allow that to happen. So if you have any other questions, please feel free to shoot us an email at product.support@lothill.com. Thank you.